Hey guys, and welcome back to another very, very exciting video unboxing with CustomPCReview.com. My name is Sam, and today we're going to be checking out the NZXT Hue RGB LED controller. Now, this is a product that I actually saw for the very, very first time. I wasn't at Computex, but I did see it from some websites who were at Computex, and they actually had, you know, they went to the NZXT booth or whatever, and they had this new product out. It was called the NZXT Hue, and this is actually very interesting because as far as I know, there isn't really anything quite like this. Now, what this does is it's actually a LED lighting kit. And what this allows you to do, though, is it allows you to switch colors between red, green, blue, or a mix of red, green, and blue. And this is actually something that obviously we haven't really seen before. And the way you control this is actually through a, obviously a controller through the 5 1/4 inch drive bay. So we can see right here, this is all the LEDs, included with the LED strip. This is a 2 meter LED strip. It's got 24 RGB LEDs, so it's got red, green, and blue. And these should be pretty bright. Otherwise, here's the control unit right here. And we can see there that it's got a brightness control with a red dial right there. And these are pushable, so what'll actually happen is you would push on each of these dials for, say, brightness, power, or mode, and then you would turn the knobs for each respective color. So you would turn the knob for red, you would turn the knob for green, turn the knob for blue, and all that. And back here, it's pretty much just gonna be one of your empty trays in the back there. And nothing really special going on. The way you actually power this is just through a SATA power connector, which is great because Molex is obviously going out of fashion these days anyway. So it is using that that SATA power connector. And right there we have that SATA power connector. There's also another connector right there that connects into the LED strip. So pretty basic to install. It's gonna take, not that much time. The whole LED strip actually has adhesive backing on the back, so it just sticks right into your case and you're good to go. So let's test this thing out. I'm gonna show you guys what it does. And I mean, this is pretty basic. We're gonna have a written kind of review on this in a little bit, so definitely stay tuned for that. It'll be in the link below when it's ready. It's not really ready right now, but soon enough. Anyways, as you can see right here, I'm just adjusting the knobs and the LEDs are actually changing colors. And this is really cool because previously to this, you can only buy LED strips that were a single color. But today you might feel like you're blue, tomorrow you feel like you're red, the day after you might feel like you're purple or something. And with a kit like this, you're actually able to change the colors whenever you want. And it's got 5 intensity modes or 5 brightness modes. As you can see, all I have to do is press on the dial and it gets brighter and brighter, or it gets less bright. There's also a couple other modes like a flashing mode right here. As you can see, it's flashing a certain color. There's also fading, color flashing. And there's actually 5 modes in total. So I'm going to show you guys what other there are. And this is sort of like a breathing mode. They call it a fading mode, but it's a more of a breathing. Here we've got a just a flashing, color flashing, changing colors, sort of like a Christmas tree. And just scrolls through all the colors. Look at all the pretty colors. Definitely very cool. And there's also changing colors there, is nice. I really like this mode right here because it changes colors and it has that breathing effect, which looks absolutely fantastic. I can just imagine it inside my case. It's gonna look absolutely bomb. So that's pretty much all I've got for you guys. I think this kit is gonna be about $35 or so, somewhere around that neighborhood. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Product shots coming along the way. Stay tuned for that. Special thanks to NZXT for sending this out for review. And for all you guys watching, stay tuned for more. Go too crazy on yanking on your, you know, cables and stuff. It shouldn't really be a problem. And right here we can see that the WASD keys are of a grippy type textured kind of key. Same thing with the arrow keys, kind of grippy there. You gotta have a little bit of a strange inner key. It's got that you know, like that European kind of layout there, with the extra backslash instead of, you know, the long enter key. So